Welcome to USA Breaking News Today. Please subscribe and click notification box to get all breaking news alert. Breaking news today. Bombshell, Obama held six secret meeting right before Trump's inauguration, look who he met with. As the mainstream media continues to claim that Russian agents helped steal the election away from Hillary Clinton, more evidence continues to emerge that this entire narrative is one giant cover-up of the actual crime regarding Hillary and her deleted emails. With each passing day, the absurd Russian story continually falls apart, pointing to Barack Obama being the criminal mastermind behind this insidious plot to take Trump down. Over the last few days, that scheme has further been revealed after a mysterious letter from former Obama National Security Advisor Susan Rice was discovered. That strange message was just the tip of the iceberg of new clues for investigators, with one major bombshell hiding in plain sight. In this letter that Susan Rice penned to herself held the clues to a secret meeting that Obama held right before Donald Trump was sworn into office. And, now that lawmakers are armed with this new information, perjury charges should be filed against all who were involved. The Obama administration was riddled with corrupt individuals, and yet for years nothing was done about it, but that seems to be about to change finally. Over the last year, the mainstream media has been busy pushing the fake Russian Trump collusion story in a desperate attempt to shift the focus off of the real criminals that are hiding out in Washington, D.C., under the Obama administration. Now, those offenders are finally being revealed, much to the shock of the mainstream media and the deep state, who are scrambling to protect themselves from possible prosecution. As we all know, top Obama officials over the last year have testified before the Senate Select Committee on Intelligence concerning the now-debunked Trump dossier that was used to obtain a FISA warrant for now-infamous Trump wiretap. During this questioning, the committee grilled former Obama administration staffers about what methods were used to determine when these intelligence agencies realized that this dossier was indeed a fake. One of the people questioned was former FBI Director James Comey, who held back critical information. And how do we know this? Well, the strange message that Susan Rice sent to herself tells us all about it. You see, in the letter that Rice sent to herself that Senator Chuck Grassley and Lindsey Graham partially declassified earlier this week shows that Comey held a meeting with Obama and failed to disclose it in his testimony. Here is more from the Daily Caller. FBI Director James Comey held a secret Oval Office meeting with President Barack Obama 2 weeks before Trump's inauguration and may have deliberately misled Congress about it, according to an email sent by National Security Advisor Susan Rice that GOP Senators Chuck Grassley and Lindsey Graham partially unclassified. The meeting, which Comey never previously disclosed to Congress, occurred in the White House on January 5, 2016. It included Obama, Vice President Joe Biden, Rice Deputy Attorney General Sally Yates, and Comey. The topic of the meeting was potential Russian interference in the 2016 presidential election. By failing to inform the Senate Select Committee on Intelligence about the meeting in his June 8, 2017, testimony, Comey may have deliberately and intentionally misled Congress about his interactions with the former president, especially a meeting so close to Trump entering the White House. President Obama had a brief follow-on conversation with FBI Director Comey, Rice wrote in an email written the day before the inauguration. The National Archives gave Grassley and Graham classified and unclassified emails about the meeting. Previously, Comey contended he only met with the Obama twice, once in 2015 and another to say goodbye in late 2016, according to the former FBI director's June 8, 2017, testimony before the Senate Select Committee on Intelligence. I spoke alone with President Obama twice in person, and never on the phone. Once in 2015 to discuss law enforcement policy issues and a second time, briefly, for him to say goodbye in late 2016, Comey's opening statement read. Grassley and Graham stated on their websites they were struck by the context and timing of this email, and sent a follow-up letter to Ambassador Rice. It strikes us as odd that, among your activities in the final moments on the final day of the Obama administration, you would feel the need to send yourself such an unusual email purporting to document a conversation involving President Obama and his interactions with the FBI regarding the Trump-Russia investigation, the two senators told Rice. In addition, despite your claim that President Obama repeatedly told Mr. Comey to proceed by the book, Substantial questions have arisen about whether officials at the FBI, as well as at the Justice Department and the State Department, actually did proceed by the book, they continued. Rice is scheduled to testify before the Senate Committee on the Judiciary on February 22. Now, that this email was discovered, it has opened up a whole new can of worms that I am sure the left was hoping to keep quiet. With each passing day, new revelations are revealed over just how corrupt the Obama administration indeed was, and we can only expect that Grassley and Graham will push Rice and now Comey to answer and not let them hide behind some obscure executive privilege clause like so many have done before in the past. It is the time that the American people knew what was happening in our government and see justice for all the crimes committed under the Obama administration once and for all. Thanks for watch. Please subscribe channel for latest news.